Hi everyone, welcome back to another video in the Web Security Academy series. In today's video, we'll be covering lab number 3 in the CSRF module titled CSRF where token validation depends on token being present. All right, let's get started. This lab's email change functionality is vulnerable to CSRF. So we've got the vulnerable parameter over here is the email change functionality similar to the previous labs. To solve the lab, use your exploit server to host an HTML page that uses a CSRF attack to change the viewer's email address. So the goal is to exploit a CSRF vulnerability to change the email address of the victim user. You can log in to your own account using the following credentials, and we've got the credentials right over here. All right, let's access the lab. And while the lab opens up, we'll open up Burp Suite Professional. So for the first part of the video, we'll solve the lab using Burp Suite Pro. In the second part, we'll manually exploit it just in case you don't have the Professional Edition and you want to do this using the Community Edition. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is log in with the account credentials that we were given. And the password was Peter. Hit login. And this is the email change functionality that is vulnerable. All right, so let's set our browser to send requests to Burp and attempt to change the email. So we're changing it to test.test.ca and click update email. All right, that was intercepted in our proxy. So let's send that to repeater and work from there. All right, in the previous lab, we had said that in order for a CSRF attack to be possible, it has to satisfy three conditions. The first one being a relevant action, so an action that if you had the ability to perform would cause harm to the client. In this situation, it was an email change functionality. If we were able to change the email of the user to one that we control, then we could use that email in order to reset the password of that account and completely compromise the user's account. And so this is definitely a relevant action. The second condition was cookie-based session handling. So the application has to be purely using cookie-based session handling in order to manage sessions. And this is what it's doing over here. So you could see the session is managed by this cookie over here that is called session. So we've got a session cookie and this is satisfied. The last one is you have to have no unpredictable request parameters. Now we could see over here, we've got the email parameter. That's definitely predictable because we know that takes in an email address. However, we've got a CSRF token, which is not predictable at all because it's just a random number. So at first glance, this seems to be not satisfied and therefore not vulnerable to CSRF. However, depending on how this is implemented in the backend, it might still be vulnerable. So in the previous lab, the way we bypassed CSRF tokens is we changed the request method over here from post to get. And in the get method, it no longer required the CSRF token. For this lab, what we're going to do is we're going to do the first check that we did in the first lab. So before we changed it from post to get, we checked if the post method allows us to remove the CSRF token. And it said it was missing or invalid, and that's why we had to change it to a get method to bypass it. So for this lab, we're going to remove it and see if that's the case. So let's hit send, and here we go. We get a 302 found, and then if we follow the redirection, you could see that the email address changed to test.test.ca. So let's alter our testing methodology. So we'll put this as number 2. The first thing to do is remove the CSRF token and see if application accepts it. Accepts the request. And then if that doesn't work, then you change the request method from post to get and see if the application accepts the request. Now in this case, it's a really simple scenario. Even for a post request, let's go back. It accepted it just by removing the CSRF token, which tells us something about the backend. If a CSRF token is present, so if we go control that, let's go back. And it's not letting me go back. So we're going to go to proxy, HTTP history, and send this to repeater again. So if we change the token to something that is not valid, let's say W instead of J, it'll say invalid CSRF token. So if a token is present, it'll check to see if it's valid. However, if it's not present, the request will pass through. All right, so this is definitely vulnerable to CSRF, and the reason we don't have an unpredictable request parameter is CSRF token is not mandatory. And so this implementation flaw allowed us to bypass the CSRF token and exploit the vulnerability. All right, so to exploit this using Burp Suite Professional, what you need to do is right-click, click on Engagement Tools, select Generate CSRF POC, and what that does is it automatically generates a POC for you to exploit the vulnerability. Again, if you don't have Burp Suite Professional, don't worry, we're going to script this manually in the second part of the video, and so you could just use your Community Edition. So the first thing you want to do is click on Options, Include Auto Submit Script, and Regenerate, and that automatically submits the form for us. Just like in the previous labs over here, you could see a form, and the action is to change the email address over here using the method POST, and then it takes in as the input parameter the email address that we want to change, which in this case, let's say test3 at test.ca, and then the Submit button. When the script is loaded, it automatically submits the form for us instead of us having to submit the button. So what we're going to do is we're going to copy the HTML, go back to our application, go to the exploit server, which is hosting our script, and put it over here. So we just pasted that, and then we're going to click on deliver exploit to victim. And here we go. It says, congratulations, you solved the lab. So now if you wanted to see if it changed the email address, we're going to click on view exploit. It'll submit it automatically. And here we go. It says the email address is test3 at test.ca. All right. So we successfully completed the exercise. If you would like to see a detailed version of the video where we both exploit the vulnerability using Burp Suite Pro and manually using the Community Edition, check out the video linked on the screen. Also, make sure to hit the share and subscribe button so that the video reaches a wider audience. Thank you, and see you in the next video.